Hi everybody, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, about to explore the old ruins of Tuzigoot National Monument. So you know me, the very first place to stop and check out is the museum, learn a little bit about the area.
Located in the Verde Valley, Tuzigoot is one of several ruins left by natives in central Arizona. The remains of this hilltop village were excavated in the 1930s and became part of the National Park System shortly after in 1939. During excavation, numerous artifacts were found, including pottery, tools, and jewelry that gave us a clue into the life of the Sinagua people who lived here. Much of these examples can be seen in the park's visitor center. At the time of this video, entry is $10 per person. The America the Beautiful National Parks Pass is accepted.
Here inside the museum, they got a lot of really neat pottery on display here. This building, in fact, was built in the style of the Pueblos, I believe in the 1930s during the Great Depression era. I think most of the stuff in here is original. They do have some stuff that's imported also, but really cool relics and things on display to see. This is my first time visiting Tuzigoot. Never have been here before in all the years I lived in Arizona. So far, it's very beautiful out here. You can see the trail here is paved. This is noted to be fully accessible, although they do warn that there are some steep sections, like right up here, off the bat, heading up the hill towards the old Pueblo. Yeah, check it out, Jerome. We filmed a video up there a while back. Been meaning to head back up there. Was gonna do it, but then COVID happened. And we haven't been back since, but we did go to the mining museum up there. And I'll put a link in the description down below to that video. Look down there and you'll see a lot of lush green habitat. The Verde River runs through here. And these natives are very smart. They built here on top of high hilltops so they could view their surroundings, and they weren't far from very verdant and lush habitat to cultivate crops and hunt and survive in this otherwise very hostile environment.
The Verde Valley proved to be an ideal location for civilization at the time. Snowmelt, summer monsoons, and the Verde River all provided much needed irrigation to those living at Tuzigoot. The floodplain below the Pueblos allowed for the farming of maize, beans, and squash. Common animals hunted for food were deer, rabbit, bear, antelope, and duck.
We've been to a lot of ruins on this channel, native ruins in Arizona. And I have a feeling this is gonna be a significant one. But I'm still just enjoying the green that we see below down there.
Right here before us, we see old rooms. This is a 110 room Pueblo, very sizable. A lot of it's gonna be up there on the hillside we haven't explored yet. But we're looking at ruins that are thought to be about 1,000 years old.
So these ruins are actually reconstructed. This place was just a pile of rubble when it was found in the early 1900s before it was excavated. Kind of reminds me of Beshbagawa. I really think it's neat that they reconstruct things so we can get a glimpse into what life might have been like here. All right, I'm standing in a room here at Tuzigoot. Jerome once again off in the background. Looks like you can come into some of these rooms. You want to stay on the trail for the most part, but this one's open. There's a door right back there behind me. This is really cool. You know, when I'm in places like this, I just try to think maybe hundreds, if not 1,000 years ago, somebody lived in this structure probably, or was in here often. Not sure if this is a residential room or what it is, but really neat to think that. All right, we are here, I think, at Tuzigoot proper. Check that out. That is impressive. Just take a minute with me. Close your eyes. Well, don't close your eyes, you're watching a video. I'm gonna close my eyes and just listen to the wind blow in the hills here. And I'm thinking about how bustling this may have been several hundred years ago to a thousand years ago in this hot climate. Although I heard at the time it was a little bit wetter, more favorable conditions for the natives to live in. And theories go that eventually all these people abandoned this area due to possibly drought conditions, maybe like 900, 800 years ago. And they just kind of vanished. And nobody knows exactly what happened. Some think they migrated to other places. Some think that modern tribes like today, like the Hopi, that these people moved on to meld with other cultures. Very much like other sites in the Southwest and New Mexico, these people traded with other cultures. They found evidence of things like macaw feathers, things that would have come from southern Mexico and tribes down there, maybe even to South America and the Amazon forest. These trade networks stretched for hundreds or thousands of miles. These people were well connected, and I think they knew a lot of the other people in the area. This is very impressive. You just see it like step stair up. Now this wasn't built in a day. It says it was built over the centuries, but still, they picked a good spot. Here's a really great view of looking downward down the hill at all these old structures built up into the hillside here, overlooking once again that verdant valley. Lots of great hunting opportunities. You've got mule deer in the area. You've got that water source, the Verde River down below, that's flowing nice. Just look at that. These people were so smart. All right, so I'm nearing the bottom section here at Tuzigoot. You know, I thought this was the bottommost section, but look down there. There's even more to see down there. Now that's off limits, it looks like, but yeah, you can walk quite a ways. I think they said the whole experience here is about a half mile, in case you were wondering, so I don't think you're gonna break too much of a sweat. But yeah. If you keep an eye out, you'll see lots of old tools, old implements, I assume, to grind stuff. I'm assuming all this was excavated here. Now we're looking back up towards the top of the hill. You really get a good look at this thing from over here. All right, let's head back up this hill. Once again, reach the end of the trail, so we need to turn around and head back up. We'll look at the top of the structure, which is the most impressive part, I would say. Here we are entering the main structure. This is neat. I wasn't sure if you can come in here, but we can. So the wood in here, I'm quite sure this is not the original, but it's probably built in the style that they would have used. If this were real, I would expect it to be covered in graffiti, people carving things out. I have seen original wood in similar structures, cliff dwellings, one at Tonto National Monument, or actually two at Tonto National Monument. If you want to check that out, that's one of my faves, and I'll put a link in the description down below. We're gonna continue up the stairs here. We can still go up. Up, up, and up. Up, up, and away here. Whew. Wow. Look at that. Look at that view down below. Wow. All I know is I conquered Tuzigoot, and I'm up on the top, checking out everything around me. How awesome is this? You may be curious, like, look at all these rooms, and where are the doors? Where are the windows? Everything's encased. Well,
from my journeys, I've learned that these people entered these areas using ladders. So they, it was more of a vertical descent to get down into these structures that you see before you. That's a style very common to all of these ruins that I've seen in the Southwest, all these Puebloan ruins.
Tuzigoot National Monument. Yeah, this is amazing. I don't gotta say anything. You saw it for yourself. See you next time.